Did you wind up getting any more poetry?
Well, it's debatable. I did get something interesting in my mailbox, but I couldn't quite tell if it was a poem or a shopping list.
Wow, that's... Well, welcome to Elf Centered, everybody. Welcome back to the North Pole. It's great to have you here once again. My name is Gavin.
I'm Beatrice.
I'm Gary.
And boy, oh boy, it is almost April here.
Time flies.
Time is flying. And this is pretty much our last month before the season kicks into gear again.
Yes.
You guys are already depressed about that.
Well, yeah, because it's going to get busy again. And if you thought it was busy before.
I know.
Well, I guess it wasn't. Well, last month or before that. Well, anyway, it's going to get worse than it is today.
Exactly.
Every year will be busier because there'll be more people on the planet, and so more children to be making toys for.
Yeah, exactly.
Unless we get lucky and
just makes sense.
But you know, April around here is spring.
The plague.
Why would you wish for the plague, Gary?
Come on now.
That is not very Santa-like.
Well, we could get to people that don't believe in it.
Okay, Gary, we cannot continue this line of conversation anymore.
Okay, well, that was maybe a little harsh, but it sure would make the line at the North Pole's DMV shorter.
That's true. And speaking of it, it's April is spring cleaning, and it's time to clean up around here before the big toy-making season starts. And we want to remind everybody that April 21st is the bulky item pickup. So if you have any bulky items around your mushroom hut that you want to get rid of, that is the time to leave it by the curb.
Yeah, I have a few things, that's for sure.
And an old couch? Boy, that thing stinks.
Well, Gary, I think we all know why my couch stinks.
I'm not saying we shouldn't. What I'm saying is it stinks. I don't know how. Maybe it did happen with me when I came over there, but it still stinks.
I think we know that it did happen when you came over there because you had just been in the reindeer quarters. Right. And you came over and you rolled around on the couch reenacting something you and the reindeers had done.
Well, you got me excited to tell the story, and that's how I get fully involved with the story.
And, you know, everybody, listeners out there, everybody knows that reindeer is really hard to get out of cloth. If anybody out there has any suggestions for me how I can get rid of the smell of reindeer, please send us an email or a letter here at the radio station, and I would be very grateful.
I'll pay for the product if it requires a product.
And in return, I'll make you some of my famous scotcheroos.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, man. I should dirty up a lot more stuff around your place.
did someone say scotcheroos?
What?
Oh, my God. Is that...
Is that...
It's Santa Claus. Man.
Did you invite
him? I didn't invite him.
He's in a foyer.
Come on in, Santa. Come on in.
Don't mind if I do.
Wow, well, this is totally unexpected.
Do I just sit here?
Yeah, well, pull up a... My gosh, yeah. It's Santa. I don't... Is it...
Look at the bee.
Did you come by helicopter? Is that the sound?
I came by helicopter. We are updating our transportation. Just for spring, and then we're going to go back to the basics, I think, back in winter. People seem to like that. If it ain't broke.
Yeah. If not broke, don't break it.
Who are you?
I'm Gary, sir.
That's right.
I'm Gavin. It's a pleasure to meet you. It's such an honor we are so shocked that you're even here.
It's a surprise for me, too, but Mrs. Claus... told me about this little setup you have here, and I thought it was good for me to... She had a very good time, so I thought I would check it out.
Well, we had a pleasure having her on the show. This is Beatrice over here.
Hello, Santa. I hope that you enjoyed that latest batch of scotcheroos I sent to you and Mrs. Claus.
Was that you?
It was. It was me.
Keep them coming. Keep them coming.
I bet Mrs. Claus wouldn't want it. Okay.
What?
No. So, It's lovely to see you.
Well, it's lovely to be here. This is the 1 week. I take a little me time before we do the whole bulk thing.
Right, before we get back to the toy making season.
Yes, it's become a year round work season for me. So I have to really set some boundaries and take a little me time. So that's what I'm doing this week.
I see. What other things? I mean, we're honored to have you here, but what other things do you do during your week off?
I give myself lots of massages. I have the reindeer go on their week-long fast. To get them in shape. And I do a little, well, this is sounds a little weird perhaps, but I take baths in the whirlpool.
Oh, the old whirlpool out by the back behind the toy workshop?
Yeah.
That's weird.
No, I didn't know that thing still worked. There's been like emergency or caution tape around it.
Yeah, I put that up to try to keep the riffraff away.
Oh, I thought there'd been like a murder or something there. Because it looked like there was like a lot of...
Well, did it say caution or did it say elf police?
I can't even remember. Well, I would imagine it said caution.
Don't believe what they say about the murder. It never happened.
Wow. Well, Santa, this is just a pleasure. I mean, we thought we had hit the pinnacle of who we could have on this show by having your wife on last month, but having you here is just, it's unbelievable.
Well, it's fun for me, and it's fun for me to get to know you. I feel like I know, what's your name again?
Beatrice.
Yes. And
Gary.
Goron?
Gary.
Gary.
And Gavin.
And Lavin.
Gavin.
The point is, we need to work together, and I think this year I'm going to really make that a point. We every year I want to improve by 3%.
Oh,
more efficiency, more inventory, craftsmanship, and I think teamwork is the focus this year. And I want to get to know you. And so, Lavin, when I see you with this podcast and Bitro and Goron, I think we have a really good shot at meeting our goals.
Well, we are behind you 100%. I mean, that's why we're here. And especially with, assignments are coming up next month. So, we're really looking forward to see where we'll be working this season. So, we certainly don't want to influence you or anything, but we're very excited to see.
Well, I've got a few ideas. I work in the mines, sir.
And perfect. How about you, Beatrice?
I work in the doll shop, specifically with the eyes. I'm on the eyes station.
The eyes have it.
You're funny, Santa.
You should do a type
You're
five.
Funny. Yeah. Do you do stand-up?
Why do you think I'm Santa? I did try my hand at comedy many years ago.
Wow, during the 80s? During the big comedy boom?
Well, the big boom in the 80s. I tried to start, me and Paula Poundstone.
Wow.
And
you know Paula Poundstone?
Yes, I do. Would you like an introduction?
Wow.
I love Paula Poundstone.
We still keep in touch.
Do you know Mitch Hedberg?
Anyway, there is a lot to be learned from stand-up comedy, and many of the requests I get every year, Santa, can I be a stand-up comic? And I say, that's not a toy.
Yeah, that's true.
Do you have that kind of power, though, or is it just toys, strictly toys, cars?
Just toys and cars and figurines and certain types of shoes and hats and bonnets and fake houses, Lincoln Logs of that sort.
People are still wearing bonnets? I would have thought that.
I'm sorry. I keep thinking it's 1815 and 16. Sorry, 1816. I forget the year. They all run together, right?
Hey, Santa, what seems to be, like, you've got the eye on the future. What's the new toy going to be this season coming up? I know it's a little early to be thinking about it.
No, Larry, that's a good question. I I think that every year I think we're going to go back to the basics.
Oh.
And every year they surprise me. Video games and drones are the big thing this year. So I think I'm hoping they'll go back to the Lincoln Logs and the Legos. Those were easy to carry, but
Cabbage Patch Dolls.
What? We're not going to talk about those.
Right.
Have you ever, Santa, have you ever gotten given a gift? You give so many gifts every year. Have you ever been putting a gift under a tree and thought, I would really like that. I would really like that for me.
The McPhersons in 94. I had just turned onto Pinewood Street, and I went down the chimney. Very routine, very typical. And I accidentally, as I was coming out of the chimney, I fell out of my sack. And it just kind of... And there was a little fireman's axe. The kind I wanted when I was a kid. And I am loath to confess this, but I felt tempted to steal it for my own. You guys had crafted it so well. You made it in the lab. One of you, maybe some of you, all of you, I don't know. It was before your time, perhaps. But I wanted that axe so bad. And that was a moral quandary. But I ended up leaving it for the McPherson boy and not stealing it for myself.
Because Santa, wouldn't that be funny if you were on, you looked at your list, your naughty and nice list, and there was your own name on the naughty list.
Beatrice.
What?
How could you suggest such a thing?
Because
he makes the list. He doesn't lie
on. But he was talking
on.
About stealing. I was just making a funny joke about, I'm sorry, Santa.
He laughed. I think you didn't mind.
I don't know if that was a laugh, more of a knee-jerk ho-ho-ho reaction. I mean, like, you laugh when somebody, hey, look, you've got food on your face, and you go, oh, whoops. But it's not like you really had a great laugh about it. You felt embarrassed about it.
You work in the mines?
Yes.
Let's keep you there. The other thing I just want to say is spring bonuses are being bonuses are being dispersed as we speak.
Wow.
So check your stockings, your spring stockings.
My spring stocking.
Oh.
That's the first thing I do every night when I get home from work. I go check my stocking to see what mails come in.
I do the same thing to Mrs. Claus.
Well.
See, that was
check her stocking.
Santa,
that's you, naughty.
Getting back to the list, I wanted to say, you know, the list is kept under such tight wraps and such tight security. But one time, I glanced at it. You know, I was able to see it while it was in transport to the sleigh, and your handwriting is just. For such a rough, I mean, you're a tough guy. You're a big guy, Senator. Your handwriting is so delicate. It's amazing.
Well, thank you for noticing. Penmanship is a manifestation of character, I was told. And it takes me quite a while to write with such clarity and elegance. And I'm glad someone noticed. Maybe I won't keep it under tight scrutiny. I'd like more compliments.
I like your hat.
What?
Nothing.
Well, Santa, I think maybe with past lists, maybe you can start a museum and just have the lists on display.
That's a good idea.
Well, I try to think out of the box. And
maybe forward. I'll put you in charge of it.
I was thinking that I had came up with a new plan for the coal, delivering the coal to you so that you can deliver the coal to the children that are on the naughty list. I mean, I worked out a plan for that if you ever wanted to hear about it.
He's asleep.
Way to go, Gary.
Why did you?
Maybe this is good. Maybe it's because he needed a rest. Maybe I should tell more stories like that.
I know.
Oh, I'm sorry. Something made... It's vacation week for me. You were saying, Beatrice?
Maybe that we could include Scotcheroos in people's stockings.
Excellent idea.
Yeah.
Listen, I gotta go. Let's wrap this up.
Oh, well, you know, Santa, we certainly appreciate you coming by and taking time from your me week to come by and visit us here. And you, of course, I mean, you know, because the North Pole is yours, you're welcome here anytime. So, of course, you can come here anytime. But I'm just extending the welcome to you anytime, of course.
It's an honor to be here and to mingle with all the little people. No offense. But I had a great time, and feel free to talk to me anytime or come up to me with any problems you have.
Oh, great.
Till the end of the week, and then things get busy again, and then we'll kind of keep things as usual, per usual.
Gotta go through your intermediaries.
What?
Gotta go through your
Yes, that's correct, through my intermediaries, the usual.
Right.
Keep the hierarchy as it is. I hate using that word, but it's true. Yeah, it's efficient.
I'd like
okay.
All right. Thank you, Santa.
Here you go, Santa.
Ow! Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh.
You okay?
Foot.
He stepped on his foot. He'll be fine, Santa.
Okay?
He's okay.
I'm fine.
He's
certainly
great.
Sorry, but I thought I stepped on a rock or something. A very solid foot. Okay.
Bye, Santa.
Goodbye, Santa.
Bye. Wow, that was my God. Santa Claus. You got your foot stepped on by Santa Claus.
I know. I was here.
I know. Well, folks, that brings us pretty much to the end. Before we go, we want to remind you that April 21st is the bulky item pickup. So if you have a couch that smells of reindeer or something other large item, get it out by the curb on April 21st. And we wanted to give you the forecast. Tonight there is continued snow continuing on until tomorrow, and then snow for rest of the week. My name is Gavin.
I'm Beatrice.
I'm Gary.
How's your foot?
Hurts.
Okay. And this is Elf Centered. We'll see you next time. You sure you're all right?
Better. If it, that big guy didn't step on my foot.
Would a Scotcheroo make you feel better, Gary? Woo!